Hello students, welcome back to my channel. Today I would like to discuss new unit of financial accounting revised syllabus of BCom first semester with effect from 2020-21 reference to Karnataka University Dharwad under CBCS pattern. In financial accounting total we have 5 units. This is the first unit, unit 1, insolvency of partnership of firm. And this is the first lesson. Now in this lecture as well as in the next one, I am going to give you some introduction of the unit 1 and question and answer which are most likely to ask in the examination for short type and 5 marks question based. Short type answers. What is meant by dissolution of partnership firm? Dissolution of partnership of firm means closing of the business firm, termination of relationship by all the partners with the partnership. Next question. What is realization account? How to close the books? Realization account is prepared when to realize the assets and pay off liabilities on dissolution of a partnership firm, or this is an account open to find the profit or loss on realization of assets and discharging the liabilities of the firm. Now how to close the books? To close the books, first step is realization account has to be prepared to find the profit and or loss account. Second, to find the profit or loss on realization account, that has to be transferred to partners in a capital account. Third, in case of loss on realization, solvent partners have to bring cash in their respective share or loss. Fourth, reserves. If it is reserves, profit and loss should be transferred to all the partners in their profit and loss ratio. Next question. What is the rule in Garner versus Murari case? In this case, one partner is solvent and at least two partners are solvent. The capital deficiency of solvent partners shared by the solvent partners in their capital ratio. And second, in case loss on realization, solvent partners have to bring cash equal to their respective share of such a loss. Now, who is solvent partner? Solvent partner is a partner whose personal assets are more than his personal liabilities, known as solvent partner. Who is insolvent partner? If a partner is unable to bring cash from his private estate to make capital deficiency, he is known as insolvent partner. What is deficiency account? When any company becomes bankrupt, at that time deficiency account is prepared. An account is summarizing the financial position of an individual or a company in danger of bankruptcy. Such cases, deficiency account is very useful. Now, the methods of accounting on insolvency. First, realization account is prepared to know the profit or loss. Second, the profit or loss on realization is transferred to partner's capital account. Step 3, in case of loss on realization, solvent partners have to bring the cash in their respective shares of loss. Fourth step, if reserves, profit and loss should be transferred to all the partners in their profit and loss ratio. Step 5, the net capital deficiency of an insolvent partner is to be found out. Step 6, capital deficiency is to be shared by the solvent partner by bringing in cash. And finally, the settlement is made between the solvent partners. Pro forma of realization account. All students must note this pro forma to solve the rest all problems based on this unit. In the realization account, two sundry assets. Here, book value except cash and loss figures are taken. Second, to cash and bank, expenses, liabilities paid or creditors, bills payable, partners, capital account, liabilities taken over. Buy side, by sundry liabilities, by book value except partner's loan, by cash and bank, sale of asset realized, partner's capital account if assets taken over, and loss transferred to capital partner's account in profit and loss ratio. If profit, it is transferred to capital partners account in profit and loss ratio. We will learn detail in upcoming lessons unit. Next account is cash and bank account. Here opening balance is taken. Realization account asset realized, that values are transferred here to partners capital account if it is realization loss of solvent partners. Buy side, by realization account expenses, liabilities paid, creditors, bills payable, etc. to be taken here. By partners loan account, repayment of loan, that figured out here. By partners capital account, repayment of capital, or if the partners capital account, partners has to bring cash from their private estate. Next account, partners account, insolvent account. Here opening balance, profit and loss account, realization account figure, realization account assets taken over by the partners, and their capital, partners has to bring cash from private estate. Similarly buy side, opening balance, profit and loss, profit, general reserve, realization account, realization account creditors paid by the partners, and solvent partners deficiency has to be figured out. Next, solvent partners. This is the final settlement. We will learn detail by taking through the examples. Partner solvent, solvent partners, here profit and loss, realization loss, partners deficiency, balance brought down here, profit loss, profit, general reserve, and realization account figure, and cash or loss, or cash if it is paid, and it has to be settled here. Now moving to the next in this unit, piecemeal distribution. What is piecemeal distribution? Piecemeal distribution means gradual realization of assets one by one or part by part, and as and when the cash is received, it is distributed among the various creditors and then partners in some particular order. How the distribution is made? First, outside liabilities has to be paid, second, partners loan, and third, partners capitals. From the outside liabilities, creditors, bills payable, bank loan, realization expenses are to be paid first. From partners loan, after paying outside liabilities, the partners loan need to be paid. Third, partners capital, the balance amount paid to partners in their profit sharing ratio. Methods of accounting. First method, surplus method, or it is also known as proportionate capital method. According to this method, first find partners excess capital as compared to the profit sharing ratio of all the partners. Now how to calculate excess capital? By taking through one example, here X, Y, Z are the partners having capital of Rs. 15,000, 20,000 and 25,000 respectively, and sharing their profit ratio into 3:2, 2:1, find the excess capital. Such a type of problem they ask for 2 marks or 5 marks in your examination. Calculation of excess capital. So in this table, here in profit sharing ratio, I have divided into 3 columns here, X capital, Y capital and Z capital in their ratio. Capital balance is given in the problem 15,000, 20,000 and 25,000. Dividing their capital ratio, X capital is least in profit sharing ratio in this case. 15,000 divided by 3, it returns 5,000, 20,000 by 2, 10,000, 25,000 by 1, 25,000. Now profit sharing ratio, capital balance is 15,000, X, Y 20,000 and Z 25,000 respectively. Y and Z capital on the basis of X, because Y is the least capital profit sharing ratio here. So on the basis of Y and Z capital on the basis of X, 15,000 it returns 10,000, and 15,000 it returns for the Z it returns 5,000. So here first we need to nil the X account, and remaining balance 10,000, 5,000 is transferred into Y and Z partners. Now excess capital of Y and Z, that is it remains 10,000 and 20,000 balance. Now on the basis of Y, Z capital on the basis of Y, first 10,000, taking the ratio it returns 5,000, then 10,000 is nil, and the balance amount is excess capital of Z is remains 15,000. This way the calculation is done. Now moving to the next, another one example. Find out the excess capital from the following particulars. X, Y, Z are the partners sharing profits and loss in the ratio of 1:2, 1:3 and 1:6 respectively. Here, the fractions ratio is given. They decided to dissolve their firm when their capital balance stood as follows: 6 lakh, 8 lakh and 10 lakh respectively. So in this case, here Z capital factor is list to take the LCM of 1:2, 1:3 and 1:6. So it returns 6. So to make here 1:2, 3:3, it returns 3:6, 3, similarly for 2 and similarly for 1. So by taking the capital balance, earlier example, same method is applied here also. So it returns 2 lakhs, 4 lakh and 10 lakhs. On the basis here, X capital is list profit and Y and Z capital on the basis of X, it returns first X has to be nil and the balance is 4 lakh and 2 lakh. So 4 lakh and 2 lakh, it is subtracted from Y's and Z's capital, it returns 4 lakh and Z capital, it returns 8 lakh. Similarly, Z capital on the basis of Y, it returns 2 lakh, Y account is settled here and the balance amount excess capital of Z remains 6 lakh. Second method, maximum loss method. According to this method, also first of all outside creditors are to be paid off first and the partner's loan is paid before the payment of capitals. But the capitals are to be returned after adjusting the maximum loss at each stage of distribution of the partners. Maximum loss means difference between the total of capitals less cash balance at the time of distribution of cash. Garner versus Murari decision applied. If we get negative capital of any partners, such a deficiency is to be transferred to the capitals of their partners in their capital ratio, applying Garner versus Murari rule. When it is not applied, if we get negative capital of any partner, such a deficiency is to be transferred to the capitals of the partners in their profit and loss ratio without applying Garner versus Murari rule. For more practical problems, we will learn in upcoming lessons. I thank for your patience. Thank you so much for watching. Look forward to see you in the next lecture. Thank you.